I had to take a video of this absolutely stunning capsicum plant. I have just picked this beauty. Smells absolutely divine, and I'm going to eat it like an apple. The reason that I really wanted to show just how awesomely productive this wee little plant is being is because at one point I had six of them. I bought seedlings, and they all got eaten down to pretty much nothing. And this here was the original main trunk, which as you can see is now quite substantial. They all got eaten down overnight. It happened so quickly. I jammed some slug pellets in there, and that tiny little wee nub was all that was left. But I left it. Thought about pulling it out and clearing the space, but I left it. And it has come away to be this beautiful plant that, you know, has now, I guess, paid for the seedlings. and hopefully will provide me with at least a few more. Remembering that, provided that we pick things when they're ready, the plant knows to produce more, which it's already doing anyway. So yeah, I just wanted to share that. How excellent is that? It's a gardening principle that I actually came across on a Facebook page called LITFA, L-I-T-F-A, and it's an acronym that stands for Leave It The Fuck Alone. Leave it the fuck alone. I've also got a tamarillo in here that is actually, tug it, ugh, there's no way that's coming out. Looks dead as, but you never know. It may very well come away. Same with these cuttings of red currants. They may very well come away. These are some black currant cuttings that, again, like, just the life on them. Absolutely amazing. So, fingers crossed the others have, again, they have some kind of a root structure because they don't want to come when I tug them. So, fingers crossed, I guess. But yeah, LITFA. I've applied it to a few things and have to say it's been really effective. When I said I was going to eat it like an apple, I wasn't kidding. Oh yeah, look at that. Absolutely. Wow, oh my gosh, that is so much better than store-bought. Loads of seeds. Like I said, I had bought seedlings, but I think this next time, I'm actually just going to keep some seeds and try growing my own. Big fan. Many thumbs up. Jump forward exactly 1 week. Quite coincidentally, I didn't set an alarm or anything. And the little tiny capsicum that was growing has grown again substantially. Our flower has turned into a little capsicum. There's another one hiding over here. And loads more flowers to come. Just loads, which is just really, really, really cool. LITFA. I love it. I love it as a concept for life, not just gardening. Can apply that to all sorts of things. Friendships, goodness. Really, really pleased with this, and I've done what I said. I have collected the seeds from the last one, and I'll probably collect the seeds from these ones as well. It's a really nice capsicum. So my packet of six seedlings, which I think cost me $3 or $4, will definitely pay for itself in the produce of this one surviving plant. Imagine if all six had survived. If you are at the beginning of your gardening journey and you might be a little bit impatient, I know I definitely have a history of that, go and grab yourself a packet of seedlings of your favorite whatever and get them in the ground. It's super quick gratification, instant garden. You don't have to wait that long ass germination period staring at a patch of dirt, and you will have vegetables or fruit or whatever it is that you choose to begin with quickly. So get started, even if it is just something small. Do it with your kids, $3 or $4 investment, and most times if you are buying seedlings, then you're buying things that are already being grown in season. So one piece of advice I will give that I always do is take your phone with you into whatever shop you go to. I love Mitre 10 for seedlings. And Google, you know, to find out if your climate's going to be suitable, to find out if there's any special requirements for the plant, if they're frost tender, etc., etc., so that you have a rough idea of where to put them at your property, and just start. The worst thing you can do is accidentally kill a couple of plants, and I can guarantee you'll learn something from it and you'll only get better at it. And in the long run, it will save you tons of money. You will know that the produce you are eating is free from sprays if you're that way inclined. You will know where it's been grown, you will know what it's been fed, you will know how it's been handled, and you'll be able to pick it fresh. It hasn't been sitting on the shelf at a shop for goodness knows how long. I'm a massive advocate for this, as you can tell. It's just such a fun, empowering thing to do in your home and to teach to your children. And finally, remember, when things look like they're having a rough time or like they might even die, the best principle to apply is LITFA. Leave it the alone. Because you never know what you might get. This is my LITFA corner over here, and so far serving me rather well. I love it. I'll see you in a few days.